More importantly, it's funny you played that song because I wanted to let you guys know I am a child of God. Alcohol is a part of my story, but God is definitely the main character, and he changed everything for me. I started drinking in my early teens, and you know, it started out as like weekends and stuff like that, like most of us. And then it turned into, as I got older, alcohol was my solution to pretty much everything. When I felt happy, when I felt sad, when I was in pain, when I felt guilty, you know, when I felt insecure. And today, God is my solution. And alcohol became my master about 5 years ago. So my husband was diagnosed with MS and years ago, and he's confined to a wheelchair. And it progressed very quickly. And as his MS progressed, my drinking also progressed to the point where, you know, it was affecting my relationship, it was affecting my job, it was physically distorting me, it was just terrible. And so you see, I was in all this pain, and if you read the Bible, you know that, you know, through your brokenness, God makes something beautiful come out of it, and it really is amazing. So my husband was in an accident, and he was on 676, he forgot his cell phone, and nobody stopped to help him. So as he sat there for about an hour, there was a little Indian man that pulled over on the side of the road to help him. It turned out to be a pastor of a church. So he brought him home, and you know, I was raised, yes, we believed in God, but we didn't pray, we didn't go to church or anything like that. And so I wanted to go to church just to thank Pastor Joe for, you know, just being awesome and pulling over the side of the road and helping my husband. He brought him home and everything. And when my husband and I, it's a Chamonix Valley Baptist Church, and when my husband and I walked into the church, neither one of us planned on staying there. I thought it was weird, you know, like I just didn't know how to pray. I didn't know much about God or the Bible. And when we walked into those doors, something changed for us. Everybody was so welcoming and we felt so comfortable. But even so, after that day, we weren't really planning on going back. But we did. We kept going back, and during this time, I'm still drinking a lot. Alcohol is still my solution. And what happened was, I you know, they talk about the gift of desperation. I thought, well, that's not really a gift, but I'm feeling real desperate right now. I didn't know how to deal with my husband's sickness at all. I was so mad. I don't think I was mad at God. I just was angry, period. And I got this gift of desperation. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to keep going to church. I'm going to try to learn. And so I went to, it was a women's conference, a Christian conference. And her name was Kim Maddox. And she was speaking on joy in the midst of pain. Another, like, what? Joy in the midst of pain? No, that doesn't make any sense to me. So she had lost her husband. And she was this happy, joyous, and free woman. And as she told her story, I'm sobbing. And I'm like, how is this lady finding joy? And so I didn't tell anybody how curious I was about it because I just felt like it was silly. And so I just went on this journey by myself, like Googling, asking my pastor, what does that mean? Like, where's the verses in the Bible that talks about that? And what happened was God was working on me. And all these things started happening to me. I'm sorry, I lost my train of thought. So all these things started happening. So my husband didn't have any caregivers, like, you know, waiting on insurance and all this stuff. And these two amazing men come into our life who became part of our family and changed us so much. And we're in pain, we're struggling, and now he has somebody to take care of him around the clock. That's joy in the midst of pain for me. So when I was drinking, I even started drinking even more heavily, and my husband was really stressed out about it. And there was a guy named Ross Lasco that started to come visit my husband and his wife, Mary Ann. And behind my back, my husband was kind of venting to him about my alcoholism, and he just couldn't take it anymore. And so, you know, Ross was like, oh, you know, why don't you guys come to Christian Life Center? You know, it's an addictions meeting. And I'm like, no, I don't need that. He said, but even if, you know, even if it's not for that, it's great worship and all this stuff. And I was like, no, I'm not doing that. So then I go on family vacation in Wildwood, and I'm on the boardwalk with my girlfriend. Of course, we've had some drinks beforehand, and there was a chapel. I didn't know there was a chapel on the boardwalk. And it was a beautiful song, so I just said to my girlfriend, do you mind going in? She said no. So we listened to the song, and this guy comes up to us and starts talking to us a little bit about God, and we got in a conversation, and he says, you know, I don't drink. You know, Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. And, you know, I just kind of shared a little bit, like, yeah, I probably should stop drinking too. And he's like, just don't drink. I'm like, well, he's a man in many words. Okay. So then shortly after that, I decided, let me try the sober thing. So I came here on a Friday night, and it was right in the beginning of COVID. So we had masks on, and I'm sitting right over there. And I said to my girlfriend, Lori, I said, oh my goodness, I think that's the guy from Wildwood. And it was Bob Sopronsky. He's the guy. So you know what? The crazy thing is that God was working in my life. He was putting people in my life to get me to where I needed to be. And then something else crazy happened. I had a friend in high school that I haven't seen her in 20 years. All of a sudden she pops up and we start hanging out. She was the one who came with me at Christian Life. And I started getting real honest with her. I was never, my friend Patty's here, she's one of my best friends, her husband Bob and my other friend Bob, and Daryl. But I got real honest, like my friend Patty, my friend Church, they all saw the way I drank. I don't know if they really knew how bad I was, but it was pretty bad. So I would share with my friend Lori all the things I was doing and how much I was drinking, and she, I think I scared her. And so she moved to Florida, but before she moved, she was really concerned about me, so she planned an intervention. And thank God, because if God did not put these people in my life, I wouldn't be here right now. And the other thing is, you know, thank God I had God in my life when I got sober, because God is the reason I got sober. These people are the reason I got sober. He put them in my life at exactly the right time because I was going to die. There was no two ways about it, and nobody really knew, except for my husband, probably. So I went to detox, and something happened to me. I was praying to God, please take this obsession from me. Somebody told me to say that to God. God, please remove this obsession from me. And so they drove me to detox that night. And the next morning, I woke up to look into the mirror, and I kid you not, I did not recognize myself. I did not recognize myself. I looked in the mirror, and I just fell on my knees and prayed to God, please take this away from me. And a miracle happened when I was in detox, because I lost the obsession. I thought to myself, this is it. Let's go. We're doing this. And I haven't had the obsession since then.
Praise God.
It's just so amazing. It's so amazing. So I went to this beautiful detox, believe it or not. I didn't think I needed detox, but I did, for sure. And with the help of my friends, you know, I got there, and the help of God, of course, that put them in my path, I got there. And it was just amazing. Like alcohol was my solution, but today God is my solution, and God is my master. And so when I got to, after I went to detox, which is a beautiful spa-like place, I was like, oh, I like this organic food. It was beautiful. Like, thank you, Jesus. And then I got to my recovery house, and Dorothy was not in Kansas anymore. It was, and right away I wanted to give up. My friend Lori called me and said, I'll get you out of there. I'm going to put you somewhere else. And I stopped for a second, and I just went outside, and I started crying, and I started praying to God. God, please let me know this is the place where you want me to be. And I know he answered me, and yes, it was, because you know what? You're not in Kansas anymore. You're gonna do this work. I got your back, and you're doing this. And what an amazing experience it was for me. I helped other girls, they helped me. We prayed together. I Googled verses in the Bible. about like perseverance and addiction, and I used to post them on the fridge for them all just for like encouragement. And it was just amazing. Like I was able to like to read some Bible verses to them and really try to get them into it. And I honestly, you know, it's so true that I forget that I did write the verse down, Bob probably knows it, but that God makes something beautiful out of your pain. Mm. You know, Amen. Joy in the midst of pain, it's true. You don't know joy unless you go through pain. And through those struggles, God builds your character and your endurance, all of those things. And I only knew that because God worked it in my life. And now I have a sponsor. I have a great network of women that are here tonight. And it's literally, God has changed my life. And for anybody out there that's struggling, that maybe you don't believe, please keep praying. Talk to me after the meeting. It's really, really amazing. I can't believe I'm sober. I'm sober for almost 11 months now, and it's only from the grace of God. I literally never thought I could do it. Without God, I wouldn't be here. But thank you for letting me share, everybody.
Amen.
All right, come on, you've got a bigger hand clap than that.